principal's report.
All right, good evening, board members. Here's my principal report on how we're moving onward, onward, ever onward here at RB. Guys, can you believe we're in week 5 of remote learning? And every day I get impressed by what the students can do and what the teachers teach. You know, I do a virtual walkthrough, I want to say, at least once or twice every few days. And guys, our teachers are preparing your sons, your daughters for college, and this is how. They're teaching them how to use a virtual platform right, how to work in breakout rooms, how to screen share, how to write digitally on a document so others can see. So you guys actually have a head start, because the college model is a blended model. There's in-person learning and there's online. You're gonna have to respond to prompts. You're gonna have to work together. So I'm really so proud, you know, of the skill set that our staff is teaching the students. You know, guys, I'm proud of you guys for experimenting, for getting better at it. And whenever I pop up, you know, I'm like, hey guys, let me see your screen share. Let me see you write on a PDF. You know, I'm checking because I want to make sure that you guys are prepared for college. But you guys are doing a nice job, and of course our staff is doing an outstanding job as well. Guys, here are also some tips for being successful in remote learning. Oh, skip the piece, excuse me. Guys, rest and get away from the screen. That's why we have the 10-minute passing period. Take a little break, take 2-3 minutes, don't look at anything, and then come back, you know, a minute or two before you have to log in. Guys, charge your equipment. Okay, student, I see something bubbling, charging. Oh, my computer died. Because then you got to reboot it. You got to reset it. Guys, you just lost 5-10 minutes of instruction. Charge your equipment. Guys, students, log in a minute or two before you Zoom class. Stay the whole time, okay? And when the teacher calls on you, I know we're flexible with some people having the cameras off, but respond, because we're checking. We want to make sure you're there. Guys, attend virtual office hours if you need extra help. Create a safe space or a workstation. You know, have your little desk, your bed, you know, but, you know, make it look like a school desk, you know? Guys, contact your teachers if you can. Guys, students, guys, do me a favor, guys, please put your phones away. I notice, and teachers notice, when you're looking at the screen and when you're looking down and away. I don't know what you're looking at when you're looking down and away, but I know you're not looking at the screen. So whatever you're looking at, guys, remove that distraction, okay? We want you guys focused. And guys, please be mindful also of household distractions. I know sometimes I've heard dogs or music, and maybe, you know, that method works for you guys. We're all different learners. But guys, just be mindful you're in a learning community. So if you're jamming out to rock or you're doing, you know, AP statistics, maybe not everyone or likes the music or gets distracted. Guys, just be mindful of your own habits as you enter a community space, okay? That's all I ask. Guys, student attendance is outstanding. For week 3, we were at 96.34. Year to date, we are at 96.87% for ADA. So our attendance is pretty good. And for our teacher attendance, we are at 96.5. Guys, we are in Hispanic Heritage Month. It is celebrated every year from September 15th to October 15th. It begins with the independence of 5 Central American countries, the 15th, the 16th is Mexican Independence Day, and it ends just shortly after Indigenous Peoples Day in October 15th. Guys, we're celebrating here at the school. We've been doing little Instagram posts as well. We had a little treat for the staff. We had concha, the Mexican sweet bread. You know, concha means a shell, so the bread kind of has the pattern of a shell. So it was really nice having teachers get involved. And we're also working with Mr. Tinoco, who just left, who is the sponsor of the Spanish Club, and Ms. Treviño, who is the sponsor of the Organization for Latin American Students, will be hosting, you know, more virtual events as well, doing some kind of virtual spirit week, you know, having treats and stuff, you know, for the staff. Race and equity. Guys, yesterday I emailed everybody an opportunity to be a founding member of our Race and Equity Committee. What are we going to be doing together? Guys, we're going to be identifying and recommending opportunities for RB to infuse equitable practices in curriculum and instruction, discipline, human resources, professional development, student growth, extracurricular programming, communications, parent involvement. Guys, everything we do, we're going to look at it through an equitable lens. And from the words of Sharon Danielson, an amazing educator, this is what she said: excellence in education and teaching is only achieved when schools are committed to equity. Ms. Danielson created the framework that we use to evaluate the staff. You know, I'm a big fan of Ms. Danielson. Our first race and equity committee meeting will be October 12th via Zoom from 6:30 to 8 p.m. I did send an opportunity for you to join. I'm assuming the first meeting is going to be very crowded. But guys, please, you know, I welcome everyone. But this is a serious commitment because we're going to talk about serious comment, and there's going to be work to do. Okay, so if you are going to join my committee, prepare to work. You know, I welcome everyone, but please, you know, this is a serious commitment to add value to what we're doing already here at RB. Student acknowledgments. I know earlier we acknowledged James Jamison for being a 2021 National Merit finalist. I also did want to, celebrate, you know, our National Merit commended scholars, Harry Adamy, Eva Funaki, Isabel Garcia, Daniel Gonzalez, Kareem Hummus, Olivia Janunas, Ella Johnson, Ryan Locke, Owen Mars, Abigail Morrissey, Tessa Wachowski, Giovannis Pradenich, James Sarkarski, Eric Watson, and Emily Hsu. Sorry if I mispronounced your name. But these are students that were National Merit commended scholars. So I want to make sure I acknowledge those students. Athletics, as mentioned earlier, our boys golf team had their senior night last week. Congratulations to all the golfers. What a smart sport. You can play that the rest of your life. And I'm a former wrestler. I got pains in my hands, my ribs, a fake tooth, you know. Can't do that as much as I did a few years ago, but nice job, golfers. Girls golf senior night is this Thursday, September 24th. Girls swimming versus Oswego East at home this Thursday, the 24th. We have girls tennis senior night Friday at home. Girls cross country this Friday senior night, and then the boys cross country senior night coming next week. Guys, please remember, technically these events, you know, are not open to the public. I mean, if it's an open space, right? If cross country is running at the park, you're welcome at that park. But just remember, guys, I'm advertising so you guys know what's going on. Feel free to follow me, you know, on Instagram as I tweet, do videos, and post pictures. There are also many students and coaches that kind of go online as well. Okay, so I'm sharing, so please, I want to avoid crowding. I just want you guys to know, okay? Activities, the RB Band Field Show will be tomorrow, Wednesday, September 23rd in the evening. Again, this is for your information. I'm sure that we'll have it virtually or stream somehow. So the RB Band will be doing a field show that's appropriate, socially distanced, wearing the mask, following all those guidelines. To all the students and community and families, of course, the IT department sent you guys an important message today at 1:45. Guys, the district purchased and installed Zoom educational platform, which will provide added security features for our virtual classroom environments. Tomorrow, students, you should expect to receive an email notification sent by Zoom to authenticate your account. Students, please complete the authentication process, because if you don't, you may have a hard time logging into Zoom. Guys, we are battling Zoom bombs, okay? It's not easy, and we're not the only ones going through it. That's why we partnered with Zoom to purchase the educational feature, which only allows students with an RBHS website to enter. But guys, I need you to do your part, students. Please check your email and complete the form that Zoom sends out. Parents, please help us, because we want to make sure that we keep a safe and sane environment when we're doing virtual learning. SATs coming up October 14 and 15. There will be no virtual classes for the freshmen, sophomores, and juniors. October 7th, there will be a student workshop led by Ms. Wilma and Ms. Lindquist. All this information could be found on our website. For practice, I believe there was a parent concern for practice. Students, you guys could always go to khanacademy.org. Khan Academy also has an application that you could download on your smartphone and practice. Send a text message, do a problem. Call a friend, do a problem, okay? Alternate, leisure, and academics, okay? So I highly recommend that you download a great app that works well, Khan Academy. Tuesday, September 29th at 6:30 p.m., we are having a FAFSA workshop, the free application for student aid, led by the Director of Illinois Student Commission, Abel Montoya, who's a very good friend of mine. So the director of ISAC will be leading this FAFSA workshop. Okay, again, it'll be virtually. The information is found on our website. Also, tomorrow, students, an opportunity to hang out with me. Okay, virtual lunch with Dr. Freitas. I know last year I did in-person lunches, pizza with the principal, but I'm doing a virtual lunch tomorrow starting at 11:20. Okay, so guys, you know, join me. Okay, let's eat together and let's talk about how remote learning is going for you all. Okay, I believe I sent you guys a reminder today as well. Guys, this is a census year, census 2020. Please complete the census form. We want to make sure we take advantage of all of our resources. And here's some data up to date. Brookfield, you're at 80.2%. Riverside, 80.3%. North Riverside, 77.7%. Broadview, 73.1%. And LaGrange, 81.1%. So the race is close, but the goal is 100% for everybody. So please complete the census form. And I believe at the end of the month, the workers will stop going to houses. So it's kind of a soft deadline. So please try to complete the census by the end of September. And that concludes my principal's report.
Thank you, Dr. Freitas.
Can I ask, is there a makeup date for the SAT?
A makeup date?
Because it's in person, correct?
Correct.
So if a student doesn't feel good, we don't want them coming to school.
Correct. I want to say I thought it was at the end of October.
It is, if I could just...
I just think we should let that be known, like share that with parents, because that's a day that if it's in person and your student wakes up not feeling well, you may feel like you need to send them anyway, and that would not be a good idea.
We'll get that out.
Okay.